This is Tea Mentor Food. How are you guys doing today? Great, fantastic. If you all have been watching my videos, you guys know that I'm on a healing journey from narcissistic abuse. Also, I am a believer. I'm a believer in the Lord Jesus Christ. And if it wasn't for him, and if it wasn't for him saving me, I wouldn't know about narcissistic abuse. I wouldn't know that I was a target at one time of narcissistic abuse. So I'm very grateful to the Lord Jesus Christ for his precious blood for saving me, and I'm just grateful. So I'm going to talk about him in my videos because, again, if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't know what I was in. And all of you all know how it is when you are a target of the narcissist. It's as if you don't know in the beginning that something is wrong. You don't know. You have no clue. You know, only thing you know that is happening to you is that your life is very repetitive. You know, you're doing the same things. You keep going through the same different stuff that you went through year after year after year, or you just gotten out of something that was similar and you're going right back into it. I know that was the case with me. It just kept happening over and over and over. I just kept on going through the same stuff. It's just like going around the same bush over and over and over. It was crazy, you know, and I just couldn't understand it. It's like, what is going on with me? Why, you know, is my life taking the same steps, never growing, just being stagnant? And that's one of the clues of knowing that you're in a narcissistic coma. You might as well say, you know, you're in the cave with the narcissist, and the narcissist is feeding you all the same type of food, different names, different people, but you're interacting with that narcissist, and it's just like the same stuff happening over and over and over. And, you know, you go through your life thinking that, okay, well, maybe this is going to be different. Maybe it's going to start turning around. You know, you're thinking like this, but then again, it just, the same stuff starts happening again. At least that was with me. And my repetitive behavior was being homeless. Every time I turned around, I was either coming out of a homelessness or going into being homeless. It was just that back and forth, back and forth. And I never could get back on track, or I never could understand what was going on with me. And when you're in homeless situations, or any situation where your mind is not able to rest and you're not able to really collect your thoughts in a positive way, you're not thinking clearly, or you're not seeing clearly. So you just don't know, you know, what's going on. You don't know that you're in darkness. You don't know that the person that you're talking to while in your homeless situation or in your chaotic situation is the narcissist, and the narcissist is going to keep feeding you the same negative stuff, and you keep giving the narcissist more power by telling the narcissist everything that you're going through. You know, you're like, well, I'm back in my car again, you know, and the narcissist, oh, wow, you know, I'm sorry to hear that. Oh, I just hate to hear that. You know, but you don't know that you've just given the power to the narcissist for them to just keep your life in that same mundane thing. You know, you're giving your power away by telling this evil being that, oh, I'm homeless again. Oh, I broke up with this, you know, boyfriend, girlfriend again. You know, I don't, you know, I lost my job, or this and that. So you keep feeding the narcissist the fuel to keep you in chaotic situations. And it's really sad, because when you're dealing with a narcissist, you think that that narcissist is really for you. You know, it's like, this person is for me. They're down for me. They love me. They want the best for me. You know, and you're not knowing that that narcissist is the door for more narcissists to keep coming in, and that is the door to keep the chaos flooding into your life. You have no clue in the beginning that's what's happening. So based on that repetitive, mundane life that you keep constantly being on, or that treadmill of the same, you are speaking idle words. you know, because you just cannot make any sense of your life. And so you're talking, more messy, trashy words are coming out of your mouth. You know, I don't understand this. So you find yourself complaining and you're whining, you're murmuring, and why does my life have to be like this? And why this and why that? And you may find yourself talking about other people that are doing good, you know. So you're speaking words of cursing, words of death, words of no life, you know. And so that's what idle words are. Idle words are words that are spoken and they're just gonna blow away. But they are words with power too, because if you keep saying those idle words over and over again, then they will start to take root. And Jesus talks about us speaking words that don't matter. You know, we're speaking words that really don't matter. I brought my darn glasses down here, but hold on, because I need to read a scripture to you guys. But he talks about the different idle words that we're speaking, and he said we're going to have to give an account for those idle words that we're speaking. And so that's what's so enlightening about waking up to this abuse, you know, this narcissistic abuse, because you realize that after all that you're going through, the same stuff, now you're like this churning butter that has now turned into this this something that is really like hard. It was butter starting out, but now it's really hard, so it's hard to get through, and you're just doing the same stuff over and over and over. You're speaking the same things over and over and over. And the thing about idle words is that not only are you speaking them on other people, but you're speaking them in your life. So it's really not making a difference in your life. It's just going to continue that same pattern that has been happening in your life. So it is so important that we start changing our words to mean something, changing our words to life, changing our words and knowing that they hold substance. And knowing that our words hold substance, it should start to help us pick choosily and be wise with our words, you know, not just to start talking about anybody or start saying anything out of our mouth, because our words really do have power. And so Jesus talks about we're going to have to give an account for our words that we're speaking just at a whim, you know, oh yeah, you know, just speaking anything out of our mouth. That's not what we're supposed to do. So this is a scripture that I'm going to read to you guys in regards to that. So Jesus is talking about a tree. Now, me, you know, my tree was under the narcissist, so my tree was this fruit of repetitiveness, the same stuff happening in my life, this bad, funky fruit of homelessness staying in my life. That was the root of my tree. That was the root, and that was the fruit. And so in that root system of homelessness and staying the same, my fruit was idle fruit, because I was speaking words that just didn't have life in them. They had death, because here I felt like, you know, what am I even here for? Do I even matter? You know, what is the purpose in my life if I just keep going through the same stuff over and over again? Do I have a purpose? You know, which is a lie by the devil. We all have a purpose and we do matter. So Jesus is talking. He says, either make the tree good and his fruit good, or else make the tree corrupt and his fruit corrupt. For the tree is known by its fruit. So if I'm going through things over and over and over, and I'm constantly homeless, and I'm constantly dealing with the narcissist, that means the fruit on my tree is bad. It's not good anymore. You know, that's my root system. It's just bad. And so being around the narcissist is enhancing the fruit that's on my tree, that's really inside of me. So after a while, I have to turn myself around and start trimming the fruit off of my tree by going inside, or allowing the Lord to go inside and start cleaning me out, so I don't have to keep this repetitive mundane, this repetitive of homelessness in my life, this repetitive of not feeling like I'm anybody or I'm worthy or anything like that. I have to start allowing myself to go inside and getting rid of this fruit. So a lot of times idle words is a situation where it's telling us we need to change on the inside. There's something going on with us that's not that needs to change. If I'm constantly homeless, I can't blame other people in my life, and I really can't blame the narcissist after a while, because I have to start looking at the fact that maybe it's something in me that keeps attracting narcissists, or keeping this door open in order for my life to stay in the same position all the time. So after a while, it's an inside job that needs to take place. So once I allow the Lord inside of me and I start changing, then my words will no longer be idle, but they will be words of substance, words that do matter, and my life will take that same effect, and it'll start turning around to say, hey, I do matter. Hey, I do have a purpose here, you know. So Jesus is talking about the fruit of the tree. And then he says, oh, generation of vipers, how can ye, being evil, speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. So if I'm speaking idle words that don't matter, then that's how my heart is on the inside. I just explained that to you. But if I'm speaking evil thoughts, that's really inside of me. That's what's coming outside of me. And so whatever is coming out of my heart is what I'm going to put out. And so after a while, I really can't blame the narcissist, you know, for what's coming out of me, because I'm creating my world from the inside out. I'm that magnet going in, going out. So whatever's on the outside, I've attracted that and brought it to me. You know, so that means there's some work that I need to do on my tree so I can change, right? So it's not about the narcissist. After a while, it's about me, because the narcissist tree is evil, and that narcissist is only doing what her insides is allowing her to do, or his insides are allowing him to do, you know what I'm saying? Because after a while, if you're evil, you're evil, you're evil, you're putting that out, and you're finding victims so that you can continue to eat off of them and continue your eating off of them and continue your destructive behavior. You know, that narcissist hasn't came to the point of saying, there's something wrong with me, I need to change. It's not my environment, it's not my boss, it's not my husband, it's not my wife, it's not my children, it's not the grocery store person, it's not the gas station attendant, it's not this person, it's me, you know, they need to change. The narcissists haven't gotten to that. They haven't started eating that, I have to point the fingers at myself. You know, they don't understand that after a while, you can only keep burning and hurting people for so long until you just start to say, well, you know what? This is me. I'm creating this idol food, and I am the captain of it. And until I realize that, then they're going to keep collecting, victims. Basically, they're going to keep collecting victims. People that feel low self-esteem, people that are too nice, people that don't really know themselves, which is okay, because none of us know ourselves until we start learning about life and learning about people. But these are the people that they're going to start collecting, you know, in their web of deceit. But we have a part to play too. We can start taking ownership of our life and you know, wanting it to go a different way. You know, when I say, you know what, I got a problem. There's something wrong with me. That's the moment that my lights are on. The narcissist has no more power in my life, because now I can see. You know, so the narcissist, they don't get to that. They don't get to seeing that it's them. They continue to let their ego run them. They continue to let their pride run them. They continue to just be this puffed up thing, you know, and they just keep idling through life with their idle words, you know. And so you and I are on the road to changing, and we're changing our idle words to substance, words of substance, words of truth, words of meaning, words of light, words of life. You know, we want to live. And so we all admitted that we were narcissist targets, you know. So when we get to that point, then our awakening happens, and now we're starting to live, and we're starting to see our purpose on this planet. But the Lord says, he says, but I say unto you that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give an account thereof in the day of judgment. For by thy words thou shalt be justified, And by thy words thou shalt be condemned. So if our words are not idle anymore, now we're starting to live justly. You know, we're starting to watch over our words. We're starting to see that, you know, our words can hurt ourselves and hurt other people and hurt our environment that we are in, you know. So we're starting to see that. But so now our fruit system and our trees are starting to gather fresh fruit, fruit that matter, fruit that really do care about people, you know, fruit that care about, you know, if they eat this, my words, will this, my words hurt them or will my words love them? You know, if we never get to that awakening point where we're not acknowledging the fact that we have a problem, then we're condemning ourselves. You know, we're living a condemned life of just existing to hurt other people. And I don't want to live like that no more. And I know you don't want to live like that no more. So we have to recognize that, yeah, we were targets of the narcissist. Yeah, we allowed the narcissist to take advantage of us and to use us and to abuse us. But now we can start being accountable for our lives. And now we can start watching our words. And now we can start inviting the Lord in to take away the fruit that hurt, the fruit that was sour, the fruit that was spoiled, because now we want to start living, you know. And so as we travel on this journey, let us just be mindful of the fact that this journey really is about us. It's not about the people on the outside. This journey is about us cleaning ourselves up, allowing the Lord to clean us up, allowing the Lord to change us, and during that change, to see that we do have a purpose here. We have a purpose, and also that we do not have to continue talking about the narcissist and what the narcissist has done, because in so many ways we allowed the narcissist, which was our inner self, our fear, a shame, our guilt, our feeling inadequate, not feeling enough, like we're not good enough, all those things, low confidence, low self-esteem, we attracted the narcissist to us, you know. So now we have to say, you know what, Lord, I feel this way in this area, but I invite you in to help me to be stronger in this area. You know, I don't feel like I'm adequate enough in situations that I go into. I invite you in to help me feel adequate enough and help me to depend on you in order to get my strength in this area. You know, so we have to just have a heart to heart with the Lord. Let him in. You know, let him in and let him clean us up. Because if he brought you to this road of healing, if he brought you to this road of the darkness that was lying inside of us, that darkness that was lying inside of us attracted that narcissist to us, right? If he brought us to the road of turning on that light in those dark areas, then that means God wants to do a mighty, mighty work in us. And he's capable of doing it. And that also means that we are ready for this type of work, okay? So be proud of yourself. Stay on this healing journey. You can do it. I can do it. We all can heal. And we can heal to live. We can heal to walk in the light. We can heal to speak words that are justified and words that do matter, okay? I love you guys. Take care. Thank you for watching my videos. I really do appreciate it. I appreciate all of my subscribers. I really thank you guys so much. I'm really, really grateful. Thank you, thank you, thank you. To the Lord be all the glory and the honor. This is T. Mentor Fool. God bless you all and be blessed.